Let's now take a look at the idea of actually calculating percentiles from the data. Now, to calculate a percentile, first of all, the measurement scale has to be at least interval. That means interval or ratio. Now, percentiles measure data positions within the data set, just like the quartiles did. Quartiles measured, as example, the position such that no more than 25% was below and 75% was above, if we're talking about the first quartile. The median was 50% below, 50 above, and so forth. And actually, like I said earlier, quartiles really are nothing more than special percentiles. Now, the typical notation for percentiles, and normally we only talk about the sample percentiles, is if I wanted the, say, the 80th percentile, so the, say, the 85th. We would write this as P85. And what that means by definition is no more than 85% of the data, is less than and no more than what's left, 15% of the data is greater than. And this idea of no more is really important. And I will get into more details about that when I do this example. So let's go ahead and go over the procedures for finding a percentile, then we'll work out an example. So first thing you really need to do is sort the data from smallest to largest. It makes no sense whatsoever to calculate a percentile, because what you're actually doing is finding a location within the data set. Go to that location when the data is not sorted, because the value you're going to find would be completely subject to the order you wrote the data down, which I could have written it down differently and somebody else would have written it down differently, but yet it's the same data. So I want to find the location by multiplying the sample size n by the proportion represented in the percentile. So as example, if I wanted P85, and let's just say that n equals 30, a data set had 30 values, the location we would find by taking 0.85 and multiplying it by 30. That's what this sentence means. Now, if the location calculated is non-integer value, well, we see 85 times, I'm sorry, 0.85 times 30 is actually going to be 25.5. So in this example, we would have a non-integer value, round up to the next integer value, and we identify that data value in that position as the desired percentile. So here, 25.5, this is non-integer. I have a decimal here. That means round up to 26. So I go to the 26th data value, and whatever number is there, after, of course, I've sorted the data, I would say that is P85. Now, if the location calculated is an integer value, so let's just pretend, well, let's just say n was 100. And of course, 0.85 times 100 equals 85. In that case, if the location is an integer value, such as this, then I want to take the average of the data value in that position and the next position. So if I went to my 85th data value, of course, after sorting, and I'm making this up, I don't have data in front of me. Let's just say the 85th happened to be 27. And then go to the next one, the 86th position, and let's just say that happened to be 29. I take that average, which is 28, and that is the value that I would call P85. Now, the reason we go up, I will show you in just a moment. When I work out this another example, I'll come back to this and justify why we take the average of the 85th and the 86th, just like I would justify here why we jump to the 26th if I end up with a decimal portion. So here's my exam data. So let's go ahead and find P85. Well, n equals 30. And I already did it up here. So I'm going to take 0.85 times 30. that equals 25.5, and that's telling me to go up to the 26th location. Now, remember, I have to sort the data. What if I don't sort the data? Well, see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There's 20, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I would have identified 83. But what if you went this way? Here's 3, so I need to go to 20. So see, 3, 6, right here would be the 26. Because at the fifth row, that'd give me 15. Yeah, that'd be 26. So see, I identified two different values simply because I counted differently, which doesn't make any sense. So you have to sort the data. You must sort the data. This is a biggie. Okay, so why is it that I go to the 26th position? Which, by the way, once I sort this data, and I actually go to the 26th position, I will find that the true 85th percentile for this data set is actually 91. 91 is in the 26th position. So again, why is it I go to the 26th? Well, if I'm at the 25.5th position, that means I'm in between the 25th and 26th. So how many do I have below? Well, I have 25. So 25 out of 30 actually is going to be 83.33 and a 3 repeats. Now remember, I wanted P85, so by definition I can have no more than 85% below. And that's good. I have 83.3. That's no more than 85. So that's fine. No problem. So that means I have 5 above. Well, 5 out of 30 will give me 16.66, and of course there's 6 repeats also, percent. Well, by definition I can have no more than 15%. Well, that's too much. So I just violated my own definition. So what happens if I go up to the 26th position? Well, if I go up to the 26th, see, here's the 1st, 2nd, 3rd, see, 24th, 25th, 26th, 27th, 28th, 29th, 30th. If I go up to the 27th, let me fix that real quick. If I go up to the 26th, there we go. How many do I have below? Well, I still have 25 below. How many do I have above? 1, 2, 3, 4. So now I only have 4 above. Well, 4 out of 30 is actually 13.33%. And I believe that 3 is going to repeat. See, this now matches definition. I have no more than 85 below, correct, 83. I have no more than 15 above, correct, 13. So that's my justification for the 26th position. Now, remember we said if we have an integer value, like before I had 1, 2, 3, let's see, 84, 85, 86, 87, back to 100. I landed on 85. Well, what do I have below? I have 84 out of 100. That's 0.84. Well, by definition, that's fine. What do I have above? Well, I have 14 out of 100, which is 0.14. By definition, that's fine. I haven't violated anything by definition. However, what happens if I take a value in between the 85th and the 86th? How many do I have below then? Well, that's 85 out of 100. That's exactly 0.85 or 85%. And how many do I have above? 15 out of 100. That is exactly 0.15 or 15%. So when I land on an integer value, by taking the value in between, that will give me exactly what I want, 85% and 15%. So although this by definition satisfied the definition, I can do better. That's why I go up. That's why I would take whatever data value is in the 85th position, whatever data value is in the 86th position, and average them. That will give me a location in between the two, and I will have exactly 85% below, exactly 15% above. Now, what happens if we try to use the idea of a percentile with, in this case, ordinal data? And obviously, it'd be even worse with nominal data. Well, if I wanted the 85th percentile, looking at this, I can't get it. I mean, there's just no way. The closest I can get is I can say that 87.5% were D's or better. And I could guess turn this around and get something maybe close to 85%. But see, I can't do any granular type work. I can't get really, really close to the 85% because I have the number of frequencies in each of these classes, or actually, this probably should say category. TCSAS doesn't distinguish between it, but technically, this should be a category. So, see, the whole idea of a percentile for ordinal data, it doesn't work. And like I said, for nominal data, it'd be even worse because there's no order to it. Now, there is no magic button in TC Stats or on a calculator, at least not the time that I did these videos, to calculate percentiles for you. You simply have to go through by hand and do it exactly the way that I just demonstrated.